What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I'm really surprised because Sendinblue just launched a lifetime deal and a yearly deal. This is a well-established company that has over 400 employees, and it's comparable to MailChimp, which is really popular also. Now, in this video, I will be covering what the pros and cons are of that lifetime deal, and the actual tool, how it works, and how conditional logic is really awesome in Sendinblue. So let's go jump into the deal and Sendinblue right now. Okay, this is the main dashboard for Sendinblue, and you will see the overall analytics of your email campaigns. I already added 722 contacts, and you will see the overall open, clicked, and blacklisted. If I want to start a quick campaign, I could just do it by clicking right here. We will get into that in a bit. Previous campaigns, draft campaigns, and this overall dashboard, right? Nothing fancy, but it's a clean UI. And like I said, the most important part about all of this is that it's a stable company and platform. Next thing we have is the emails. If we want to start an email campaign, we can start from right here by creating an email campaign. We'll get to that in a bit because that's not like the most important part of all. Templates, let's see how powerful they are in templates. For that to load, let's load in a new template. All right, so let's call this template name test, subject line test. This is all for demo purposes of this video. Obviously, you would add something better, right? You got advanced options right here to customize UTM parameters, enable mirror link, so on and so forth. Let's go into next. We have three options: the drag and drop editor, rich text editor, and paste your code. In this case, we're gonna go into templates. So we're gonna go into template gallery. Obviously, the drag and drop editor is gonna enable once we select a template. Now, these are the templates that are available. Not many. Let me go up to 96. And these are all the templates that are available. Obviously, from these templates, you're gonna build your own and create your own creation that's gonna be customized. But if I would like to use, for example, I don't know, this one. Let me click on it. There we go. And it opens up the editor. Now, the elements are on the left. You got the image gallery, design elements, content elements, and footer elements. Basically, all these elements are already in the templates. You will see them right here. If I click on one, the options are on the right. So if I click on these icons, we have this available. One of the biggest main features that I think Sendinblue has going for it is the conditional logic. So in this elements, if I select one of these, for example, I don't know, a promotion, I don't know, let's just say that was a promotion and there's a coupon there, I can enable a conditional logic, for example, to display or not display depending on the contact that I've added with the tags. For example, contact attributes, all right? So if the contact attributes, last name, I don't know, let's just say one of these, the SMS, let's just pretend that that means, I don't know, it was the birthday or something like that. We'll say is not empty, then you will pop up this right here. Remember, we just said it was a coupon, right? So that conditional logic works here. So when you send out these mass emails, if that person is displayed with this conditional logic, it will show that coupon that we mentioned, all right? So little conditional logic there that I think is cool. Obviously, there's more in the automation. So if you like what you see right here, you can send the test for email or you can save and quit. And you got a template ready. Click on that. Not much to see in the editor, basic options, click each one, change the image, add links. Just wanna throw that out there. All right, so here's the template. If we can view right there, we can send it out and we can just save and quit for this purpose. Next thing we got is statistics. Obviously analytics, when you send out the campaigns, you will see the nothing extraordinary about analytics. You got recipients, open, clicked, and all of that stuff, right? Settings, you got your default settings right here, your test list, if you want to add for all the testing purposes. You unsubscribe page, we can personalize this one if we like, and you can create more. So for example, if I want to create another one, let's go to the new editor, name this one test. Design, obviously these are the elements that we have available, which is title, text, image, and divider. So you can add something more customized, right? So it's not just the default unsubscribed ugly thing. You can write something else like, hey, we're sorry that you unsubscribed and we want you back. Please do consider resubscribing, and that's your own thing, right? If you like your template, go to next. You can do the URL redirect or just confirmation. Next, the confirmation, you're unsubscribed successfully, and you can customize that also. Go to next and done. Okay, and we got a new unsubscribed page. Let's go back into settings. We got Google Analytics and social if you want to configure those, the global calculated values, webhooks if you need to send out information based on clicks or based on open rates or other stuff. That's pretty interesting one. Let's just go ahead and open up. Add hooks. All right. The URL, obviously you're going to grab it from the service that you're going to use. For example, Zapier, Integroman, Pavly, bunch of other more. And there's, you can use the webhook there. When a message is marked as spam, then you do something, you trigger it. The webhook does basically what it does. If this happens, do that. And with these webhooks, you can do a bunch of things, all right? So you can modify something on WordPress, with WooCommerce, with Shopify, with Magento, and a lot of things. Add them to another list and endless possibilities with webhooks, all right? But these are the options that you have available. Like if it's marked as spam, if it's open, if it's clicked, soft bounce, so on and so forth. And you add that webhook so it triggers each time that thing happens, all right? Go back into settings. Your sender domains, obviously, for example, you saw mine, the Gmail one, but if you need to add your own custom one, you add it right here. Get a dated IP, that's a buy option, and conversions. Now let's go into automation. Automation, I like it because it's simple, it's easy to use, and you have a ton of options there. Now you have some basic templates, so let's just say if you wanted to use this for an abandoned card, they give you the option of how it's going to flow, all right? So what it's telling you is, if the event card has updated, it's gonna wait 2 hours. It's gonna send the email based for the abandoned card and then exit and restart workflow. So it's gonna exit. And if any of these conditions are true, like submitted events, submitted event card delete, so on and so forth, it's gonna restart the flow. Other ones could be like a product purchase. So after a minute, they're gonna get the email for the product purchase. The welcome message, which is one of the most popular ones, is like when a subscriber comes in, you trigger one of these messages, so you create an automation, and you got more available right here. Not many, gotta be honest, but the most important ones are there. The idea is that you build from this, okay? So we'll use the welcome message, which is a popular one, and what it's going to do is when a new contact is added to this, it's gonna wait 2 days and it's gonna send a welcome email. So let's go ahead and create. All right, let's wait for that to load. I won't be sending it out just in case, but I got my Facebook group there. I'll be just adding that list. All right. So when is this going to send out? I'm going to say it after 4 days, and we have the options, minutes, hours, days, weeks, and month, right? So after 4 days, I want to send out which email that I've already created. Remember, we have templates available. So I could just say welcome mine, which is one that I created. And I want to send a hidden copy of this email. I want to choose when to send this email. So if you want to schedule it, that's possible. Use my events data to customize the email. And if we're good to go, finish. So this is a basic automation that's just created. Hey, what happened? All right, it updated. So when a contact is added here, it's gonna wait 4 days and it's gonna send the email. We can make this more powerful, obviously. So for example, these are the starting points. So when a contact is added to the list, it's gonna start that, but we can add more entry points. So with the email activity, contact details, contact submits a form or website activity. So I created a form before this, and if I want to add a contact when the form is filled, so if this form is submitted with an email, it's also going to start this same flow for the welcome. So if I add a contact to the list or if they fill out the form, it's gonna start this flow, and we can see it connected right here like a water flow. And we can add more entry points. So the waiting day is 4 days. It's gonna send out this email, but we can further customize this. So let's go into and start now. We have actions available. So you can send emails, SMS, notifications, contact list info, call to a webhook when something happens, updated contact attribute, add another delay. So we can say, and that's something first I will be doing the if and else. We can wait until or if and else condition or A/B split testing. So we'll add the if else condition, which is gonna be one of the most popular ones that you will be using. And for example, if the email marketing activity, let's go, is opened, clicked, or unsubscribed, in this case, we'll use a pretend clicked. So if any of the campaigns are equal to, starts with, contains, or equals to expressions, all links, it's clicked, okay. Then we get a yes or no. So if something is clicked, we can leave it like that, or we can add another email. So for example, send an email. And let's just pretend we have another email for the, simple confirmation. We'll go okay. And we have another email. No, we'll add a delay for this one. We'll add a delay for this one to another 4 days. Okay. And we'll add another email. And we'll use the same welcome email. For example, well, no, but that's for clicked. My bad. We'll pretend that the if and else was not open, right? If all the campaigns at all times is opened. All right. So if it's open, it's going to send this email. And if it's not open, it's going to wait 4 days and I'm going to resend the same email. Just as examples, right? You can go more into customization and more logics and do all that. Now we have the exit and restart workflow. So in this case, we can also provide conditions to restart the workflow. This one's the exit workflow and this one's the restarted, all right? Obviously, for a welcome email, this is not something that you're going to use because you don't want to resend the welcome email. But if it were something else, you would like to do like a restart condition right there. Depending on the email activity, the contact details, the contact submitted form, or the website activity, and you get all these options available. A contact visits a page, a contact clicks an external link. So for example, after that, you can, if this were a coupon, you can resend the coupon. If it equals, starts, contains, or regular expressions to this link, it'll restart the flow. Like I said, this is the good part about Sendinblue is that they have a lot of customization in the conditional logic. So it's customization for conditional logics inside of each email based on the contact information and also right here on the automation. So I can activate this workflow, which I won't be doing because we're just demoing this for the video. Now let's go into this little plus sign because there's some extra features right here. Like we saw in Sendinblue, the lifetime deal, you get included 5 landing pages, which is a pretty deep feature that you're getting it right here in this lifetime deal. So even if you don't use the email service for sending out emails or don't send out as often, you still get that landing page that you can use. So these are some extra features, app integrations that you have available that you can turn on or off. So let's just say you don't want to use automations. Well, just turn it off, transactional emails. So send personalized emails via integration API. If that's something that you're not going to use, you can turn it off. The landing pages, I turned it on. And we also have these also available. So SMS campaigns, transactional, Facebook ads, inbox, chat, and CRM. Let's go check out the landing page, which is one of the popular ones. All right, and here we go. Let's create a brand new landing page. I already created one for testing, but let's do one in this video. Cool thing about this is that you can actually add your own custom domain connected via CNAME. So that's pretty cool that we have that option. So these are the templates that are available right now. These are the all, so we're viewing them all right here, just so you get an idea how many templates there are for the landing pages. So basically not many, probably like around 8 to 15 templates about. And you can select any of the ones you want right here. You can preview them or you can select them. So for example, I'll select this one and it's gonna open up the landing page editor. So in this case, I'll call it Untitled 2. And we have the editor right here. So if we click on any of these elements, we can start editing. You're gonna change colors, change style, obviously the links for the buttons that are added. We can get rid of them, we can add more buttons. And these are the options for each one of these. One of the things I wish they had is that we can click on something and hover it and just put it anywhere in the landing page, but that's not available. We have the elements on the left. These are the basic elements, text, image, button, divider, etc. Nothing fancy in the page builder, just to give you that heads up. We have sections available, which is sections from other templates that are available and you can add them right here. So for example, pre-filled. For example, if I needed headers, let's go check out. These are all the headers that are available. Obviously you customize that to make your own landing page your own, all right? How it works, and then we got these available. Okay, we have the layout. You got the sections right here, boom, 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 boom. You need to drag these, drag it on top, drag it on bottom, good to go. The pages, if you need to add more pages to the menu, you can add them right here. So create a blank page. We have the thank you. And in the bottom, we have the email sending information. Now, if we wanted to launch this, going to launch. You must select the containing list. I know that's what I want to do. Launch. All right, so here we have to connect this email opt-in because that's the whole idea of this, so they subscribe. So we're gonna add it to my SaaS master folder, the contact list, your first list. We're gonna add contact fields, and we have these fields available right here. If we need to create more fields, we add them there. Redirect options, opt-in, design, spacing, a lot of things that if we cover this in the video, we're gonna take hours to do it, but the options are there. So let's go to launch. Okay, this is our page by default. If you don't want to use custom domain, if you wish to use a custom domain, you use it right here. And if you also want to embed, you have that option. For custom domain, let's just pretend if this was, for example, landing.sassmaster.net, connect, we're gonna get the options, and we have the options for TXT file that we have to add on our DNS settings and the CNAME. But if we don't, we publish now. We'll use this link. Let's open it up, see how that looks. And here it is, the landing page. Loads super quick, super light. You have your own landing page. Obviously use your own custom domain so it looks more professional. And you have that available. You get 5 landing pages in the lifetime deal. And on the annual, you get more landing pages depending on the license tier that you jump to. All right, let's go back. Okay, and lastly is the sender IP. If you want to add that, there's SMTP and API. Really popular if you're a developer and you want to customize something, or if you want to have a developer connect through this via API, you have that available. Obviously, I will be deleting that key so you don't use mine. So that is the overall features of the Sendinblue Premium plan. My opinion is that since it's a well-established company, I will be keeping this deal because I will be going through a process where I will be needing a specific conditional logic that this has, or an integration that another service doesn't have and this does, and that's why I will be keeping it. The downside is the 5,000 emails sent per month. For some people, it could be like, you know what? That's crazy. I don't need that much. And a lot of us, it's like, you know what? That can't be enough. Because if you have a 3,000 subscriber list, right? If you have 3,000 contacts, if you want to send them 2 times the email in a month, well, you're over the limit. That's 6,000 emails. So that's not enough. But if you have a subscriber list of 1,000, well, you can send 5 times to those subscribers in that month. So you get a sense if this is a deal or not for you. But having it, because it's a well-established company, I think it's a good way to go. But at the end of the day, if you have other email providers that are doing good for you, they have good automations, they have good service and everything, then you can skip on this one because of those sending limits. And if you want to jump into the annual plan, because you want to use their really great features because it's a well-established company and you're willing to pay the monthly plan, then you get obviously more limits. But remember that the renewal price will renew at the original yearly price from their site. So not this discounted price, okay? So consider that. Well, guys, that is Sendinblue. I thank you all for watching. The link for this deal will be in the description. It's an affiliate link. If you buy through that link, it helps me out with a small commission, and it won't cost you a single cent more by using that link. So it helps me out. I thank you all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.